So IPMAT 21 Rotak examination. So basic idea is once the IPMAT indoor exam is over, what do you need to do for Rotak exam? Very close, and what do you need to do in that particular small space of time that you have? My name is Patrick. I've been training students for IPMAT as well as the CAT. I've scored 6 times CAT 100% time. Fairly comfortable with the various strategies as far as the exam is concerned. Coming to the paper pattern, how is Rotak different? One is, it's a speed-based exam. You need to go really fast in the Rotak exam. Unlike indoor, is a more of a logic-based exam where you need to think and try to solve the question. IPMAT Rotak is more to do with speed. The faster you solve, the better it is. The questions also tend to be easier in the Rotak exam as far as indoor exam. Also, if you look at time per question in Rotak exam is comparatively low. There's a logic section in the Rotak exam which is not in the indoor exam. The one whole section is new as far as Rotak exam is concerned. And it's important to score in that section as well. So what do you do after the indoor exam? One is write a mock exam. Okay, after you finish the indoor exam, write a mock Rotak mock exam so that you can plan your strategy. So one is to get used to the speed-based exam, because indoor was a slow exam, you need to think and solve. Rotak is a speed-based exam. To get used to the speed-based exam, just write a mock so that you get used to the exam before the actual exam. Also, it'll help you to finalize the strategy. So what to do, what not to do, what to solve first, what to solve second. So finalize the strategy based on the mock that you write. Okay, it'll help you to finalize. Also, since the logic section is not there in the indoor exam, you can practice some of the logic questions. Some question which you have not solved before or something, that just practice it. Logic section helps with more practice to improve. So if you can practice few of the logic section questions that come in the examination, that could help you to improve. And last, read for some time before the exam. Just reading newspapers or books or novels. Because normally what happens is if you read, you get tuned to the verbal section of the examination. So read for half an hour, 1 hour is what I normally recommend. Okay, just reading. And last, but very important, is to de-stress yourself. You've given an indoor exam, you're giving a Rotak exam, and there's a lot of stress level that is built up. And stress is not good for an accurate examination. So my recommendation is maybe watch a movie or somewhere de-stress yourself in some way or the other. To spend around a couple of hours just de-stressing yourself, relaxing, trying to do what you enjoy, what you like. Okay, I know there's not too much time, but spend that time to de-stress yourself. It's important. So after you work on all the Rotak exam, just before you sleep, maybe de-stress yourself and just relax and go to sleep. That should help you to be in a right time, right mind frame as far as the Rotak exam is concerned. Thank you.